Good morning, students. Welcome to computer class of 9th standard. Today, we will continue with the chapter number 7, Input in Java. As in the last video, we have discussed the various next methods like next, next line, next short, next int, next long, next double, next dot char at zero. Today we will discuss has next line, has next short, has next int, has next long, and has next double. And this we will discuss through page number 135. So the first method is has next. Returns true if this scanner object has another token in its input. Token means any word. So if the scanner object has next word, it will give true, otherwise returns false. So the syntax is public boolean has next. Public is assess specifier, boolean is a data type that give the answer in true or false, and has next will check the next token. Next is has next line. Returns true if this scanner object has another line in its input. So next line function will accept a line. Syntax is public boolean has next line. Again public is assess specifier. Boolean will give the answer in true or false, and has next line will check the another line in the input. The next is has next short. Short is a data type that accept the small value in integer, like roll number we can accept in short. Returns true if the next token in this scanner input can be interpreted as a short value. The syntax is public boolean has next short. Now next is has next int. Returns true if the next token in this scanner input can be interpreted as a int value. Int means integer value, that is without decimal point. So the syntax is public boolean has next int. So int is used when we have to accept marks or total marks of a student. So the next is has next long. Returns true if the next token in this scanner input can be interpreted as a long value. Syntax is public boolean has next long. So long is used to check the value. So if we have accepted the value as a phone number that have more digits, or we can accept the distance from one place to another, so it will check the next value as an input. The next is has next float. Returns true if the next token in the scanner input can be interpreted as a float value. So float is used when we will accept the temperature or salary of a person that is in a decimal point. The syntax is public boolean has next float. That will give the answer in true or false. The next is has next double. Returns true if the next token in the scanner input can be interpreted as a double value. The syntax is public boolean has next double. So double data type is used when we want to read the scientific readings, the location of celestial bodies and their distance with the decimal point. Now students, we will open BlueJ and do one program to use the has next method. Students, we will open BlueJ by clicking on start button and BlueJ. The BlueJ window will appear in front of us. Here we will click on new class button and we will type a class name, that is message. Click on OK button. See, the class icon is created. We will double click on this class icon to open it. Here we will press Ctrl plus A to select the code and press the delete key to delete it. So now to use the scanner class, we have to import a package. So we will write import java.util.star semicolon enter. Then we will write public class message, that is our class name, enter curly bracket start, public static void main round bracket start round bracket close enter. Now the main method bracket will start. So here we have to accept a line, so for that we will write string S. String is a data type that accept the sequence of characters, and S is a variable name. We can write any variable name to accept the input. Then double quote start. In double quotes, we will write our message, that is hello world, exclamation mark, double quotes close, semicolon. You can write any message, whatever the message you want to print. Now we will write our scanner class, scanner SC. SC is the object name that we have created of scanner class, equal to new scanner round bracket start. In the round bracket we will write our variable name where our message is stored. So now we have to write the hasNext method that check is there any next line in the input. So we will write system.out.println round bracket start sc, that is object name, with object dot we will check the next input, has next line round bracket start round bracket close and one round bracket whole bracket will close semicolon. This statement will check the next input. If the input is there, then it will give the true answer. Now again we will write system.out.println round bracket start sc dot next line round bracket start round bracket close and again one more round bracket will close. So sc dot next line function will print the message on the screen. Sc is the object name, dot that is used to call a method, that is next line, that will print the message on the screen. Again press enter and we will write system.out.println round bracket start sc dot, again we will write has next line because it will check if there is any another token as a input. So we will write has next line that will check a next token round bracket close semicolon. Now again curly bracket is closed, that will be a main method bracket, and again one curly bracket will be closed, that is for the class bracket. Then we will click on compile button to check the program for errors. See class compile note syntax errors. Click on close button, right click on the class icon, or you can say on the program, and click on the void main. See, firstly we have written has next method, has next line, that has given the true answer because there is a sentence is there as an input. Then it will print the message, that is hello world, with the next line function. And again when we have written has next line, it has given the answer false because there is no any input we have given. So students, this way you can use the hasNext functions in your program. So students, today we have discussed Different has next methods like has next line, has next short, has next int, has next long and has next double. So students, do the practical practice of the program. Revise the define and explanation and syntax, and in the next video we will come with next topic. Thank you very much.